1, 2, 1, 2, 3. I was headed out your door, determined that I would go, when a tornado warning came on a music show. I was scared of the howling wind blowing around the town, so I quickly changed my plans and I settled down. Yeah, but it was no tornado. Saved by the warmest part of your soul. I looked to the east, birds were flying by. I looked to the west, I saw a darkened sky. All of the world was turning, all in that dreadful storm.
Okay, we're back. One more hit record. Hold on. This is the end. Now, this one's got a nice little hook on it. Great guitar work. That's my buddy Mike.
It's getting too late. You don't have to stay around.
This sounds like a TV show, Friends or something type music, doesn't it?
Now, it's okay. It's okay.
You gotta admit, this is pretty catchy music. All right, that's enough. Now I'm probably 32, 33, and I'm now buying a house. My Lisa and I are now married, and again, I'll show some pictures of that. It was a great ceremony. Lisa and I actually sang at our own wedding. You know, Lisa's very musical. She's got a great voice, and her whole family sings. Me, I got this, like, Rod Stewart rock and roll voice, but I was pretty good on guitar, though, because I was in a rock band. So we actually sang a song at our wedding reception. And I got to tell you, I was more afraid of singing that song than I was about getting married. I mean, it scared me to death to have to sing a song at my own wedding reception. But I'm glad I did it. It was a lot of fun. It was very sweet. We had nice harmonies. So anyway, so when we were getting married, we decided to buy a house. Well, in Long Island, it is not easy to buy a house. Very expensive. Even back then, we couldn't afford it. Harry was paying me okay, but he wasn't paying me great. So anyway, we bought this house with my sister, Laura. Now, my sister, Laura, is about 10 years younger than me. And because we grew up in such different times, we never really knew each other that well. But as she got older, we became pretty good friends. And I got to tell you, I probably talk to my sister, Laura, right now more than I talk to any of my brothers and sisters. We really became close friends, especially since my mom passed away. Didn't expect that. My mom was the one who sat down and listened to all my crazy stories and all my crazy adventures. And when she passed away, I think it was 95 or something like that, she had a heart attack. It was kind of sudden. She lived a little longer, but they had moved to Florida, my mom and my dad. So I used to go down and drink a cup of coffee with my mom like once a week, and then she would want to know all my crazy business escapades. And she was such a big supporter of all the crazy things I did. And when she passed away, I really missed telling those stories. My sister Laura now has taken that position. We talk about once a week, and she's always like, "All right, Kevin, what are you doing now?" I mean, even her husband's like, "You know, you drank the Kool-Aid with Kevin." She believes I should be the president because I say so. You know, I say a lot of crazy things, and I do a lot of crazy things, and I've done a lot of crazy things, and you're going to hear about them all. But my sister believes in me, and you know what? That's fantastic. And now, listen, my wife believes in me too, but it's different. You know, my wife, she's heard the stories a million times. You know, that's how a wife is, and she's kind of like, you know, you told me this 3 times, Kevin, I'm done. Whereas Laura, this is the first time hearing this stuff. She loves hearing the crazy stories. So anyway, she's a big supporter. So we became very, very good friends. But anyway, the reason how we got close is that we bought a house together in Long Island. And the plan was we owned it 50-50 because we could only afford half a house, it seemed. I was going to live in the downstairs. She was going to live in the upstairs. So we bought this house, and we had to remodel the upstairs to make it nice for my sister before she got married. And I also remodeled the downstairs. And Elise's dad, Dennis, was a big part of my life back then. He was just a wonderful guy. And he was older than me. He was like 15 years older than me. So I, like, he was almost like a friend, not so much a father-in-law. Very handy guy and a very encouraging guy. Every time we worked together to build things, I was kind of handy, but he knew everything. But he always made it sound like I was the one that knew everything. Like all the good ideas were my ideas when they were his ideas all the time. He was just that kind of a guy. Dennis was a wonderful guy and was always helping me do stuff around the house. We built things together and we did all sorts of stuff. But anyway, so Laura and I bought this house and we renovated it. Well, while we were living there, I'd say about a year in, the cesspool kind of got full. Now, back in those days in Levittown, there was no sewers. There were cesspools. And cesspool was a big thing that was below the ground that all the, like, gray water and black water would go into this thing, and it would seep through the ground. Most people know what a cesspool is. Well, at some point in time, those things get clogged up and they get full, and you have to either empty them or you got to build another one. So it was like $1,200 to put a new cesspool in. And we weren't wealthy people, so... I told my sister Laura, I said, Laura, we got to get a new cesspool. I said, the thing's overflowed and it's already been like pumped three times. It's too clogged up. We got to build a new one. She's like, oh, but how much is that going to cost? I said, well, I don't know. The guy told me like $1,200. She's like, $1,200? We can't afford that. And I said, no, we can't. I said, so I have a plan. Because, you know, I always have a plan. I always have ideas, right? She goes, what's the plan? I said, we're going to build our own cesspool. She goes, what? I said, yeah. I said, me and Joe, we're going to dig the hole all the way down 8-10 feet, make it round, and we're going to buy the blocks, the cesspool blocks at like Home Depot or something. We're going to place them in there, and then we'll make a pipe from the old cesspool to the new cesspool so it drains into this thing. I said, it should be a piece of cake, not a big deal. If we do it ourselves, it costs us about $200. We'll save $1,000. We'll do that $1,000, we're going to take a trip to Florida. Because everybody that lived in New York just died to go to Florida, especially in the winters, right? So she goes, well, I don't know, Kevin, if that's a good idea. I'm not sure Joe's going to want it. I said, don't worry about it. I'll take care of Joe. I said, we're going to do this, right? So that was my plan. She seemed nervous about it. I think she kind of told Joe, but this was her husband, Joe, and Joe and I get along great, but he always saw me as a little bit crazy. Well, I never brought it up again for like 2 or 3 months. And this was like in the summer, because I was trying to save up some money to do this. So she forgets about it. I'm sure Joe forgot it. Well, November comes along, and all of a sudden, it's Saturday morning, about 8 o'clock in the morning, and you can hear a truck backing into the driveway. Beep, 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 right? So my sister comes down and goes, what's that? And I said, that's the Home Depot truck. She goes, what are they doing? I said, they're dropping off the blocks. She goes, the blocks for what? I said, the blocks for the new cesspool. She goes, what? I said, yeah, I told you a couple months ago, we're building a cesspool. She's like, well, I didn't really talk to Joe about that. And I said, don't worry about it. She goes, well, he's sleeping right now, so I don't think this is a good time. I said, do you tell Joe to set the alarm for now? And he's upstairs, and he heard me, and all of a sudden you hear, boom, boom, you hear Joe fall out of the bed upstairs, right? She runs upstairs, and of course, he's saying, your brother's nuts, and she's like, he's my brother, you gotta go along, right? So Joe comes out dressed, I'm dressed. We go in the backyard, we unload the blocks. Well, you know, Joe's like a big guy, muscles. I'm this goofy, skinny guy, you know, not really skinny, but I was kind of older. You know, I was like 10 years older than him. Joe's carrying 3 blocks at a time, like 30 pounds each, 90 pounds. I'm carrying 1 block, and after 2 blocks, I'm like, I gotta rest, Joe. You know, he did most of the work unloading the truck. And then we start digging. Well, I said, I'm gonna start the hole. So I start digging. Well, it's November. The ground's like rock hard in November in New York, right? Trying to get the shovel. I got down about 6 inches, then I went, ah. And you know, I had like a bad back. I had done this a few times. I was like, oh, Joe, I think I hurt my back. I need to take a rest, right? So I sit down. Joe's like, give me the shovel, right? Joe's digging the thing. Well, like 2 hours later, Joe's in this thing, like up to here. He's dug the whole hole just about. He takes a break. I'm like, Joe, you're doing great. Now I'm sitting on the side of the hole saying, Joe, keep rolling, man. You're doing great. We're going to Florida. This is going to be a great vacation. It's not going to cost us a bit. He's like, you shut up. Right? He was like totally ticked off. He dug that whole hole all the way down about 8 feet deep. It was above our head by the time he got done. I'm like handing him sandwiches and stuff. Keep going. Don't take a break. We're almost there. Well, then Elisa's dad shows up, right? And because he was the guy that like had the brains about how to do these things the right way, because I didn't know what I was doing. I'm just digging a hole, right? And he's like, well, we got to position the thing this way. And you know, Dennis helps me position the pipe so that it'll do the water the right way and all of that. And as soon as he positioned the pipe, we were kind of done. I'm like, Joe, take a picture of me and Dennis. I throw him the camera. Me and Dennis are in the hall like this with the pipe. Like, we did all the work. Joel thinks of you bitches. He was ticked off, right? Well, we found out after we dug that hole and set this thing up that there was actually two cesspools in that yard, and we dug a third. We thought there was only one. We dug the new cesspool literally 6 inches away from one that was already there. I mean, it's very possible that that whole wall could have collapsed. We could have been killed. We could have been buried in poop. You know, to our, we're 8 feet down, and I had no idea. So we were very lucky. But you know what? We put the blocks in. We put the pipe in. We put the cover on. They have these concrete, like, round covers for them. We put the grass back, and it worked out great. We saved $1,000, and we used that for a vacation to Florida. So anyway, that's part of the stories with my my sister and her husband. We had a great time living in that place together. We really became very good friends, you know, upstairs, downstairs. You know, very often when you know, when you have siblings and you live together, especially with their husbands and wives, that's kind of a recipe for disaster in many families. But in my family, it always worked out great. We always loved each other. We loved hanging out. Elise had Rebecca in that house, and Laura had her first Taylor in that house, and we really became close friends. And the kids, even though they were young, they became good friends. I gotta tell you, when I finally left that place and moved to Florida, you know, it was kind of heartbreaking to leave them, to leave Long Island, and especially to leave Elise's parents, because me and Dennis became such good friends, and her mom was wonderful too. They helped out a lot with the baby. So anyway, so that's some of the stories. Before we went to Florida, the next video we'll talk about why I went to Florida and how I got there.